actually written down here that I get nervous when I do a presentation, especially against a tough crowd, so be gentle and forgive me for fidgeting and things. pardon me. So stewardship. I think the subject of stewardship is a tough one. It kind of gets in the way of why we're here on a Sunday, any day that we come into Christ Church. And I was putting my thoughts together last week. It was right in the midst of the NPR fundraiser. So it's kind of like when you're trying to get the news and you're listening to NPR in the middle of the pledge drive, all you get, of course, is the pledge drive. But however, if you do persevere and you listen through the appeals and by participating, you always get the benefit of an institution that really is marvelous and rich, especially in times that we live like we live in today. Unfortunately, though, for stewardship here, we don't have matching pledges or seats at the opera or tickets in the orchestra at Hamilton, I'm afraid, in our fellowship campaign. But we do have other things to offer, and I wanted to just say a few words on some words that came to mind. You know, the words that came to mind as I was preparing this is family, community, commitment, and responsibility. So let me start with family. My father, he just turned 87 the other week, and he knows he has an extended family here at Christ Church. He's visited us here, and every week when we talk, he asks about the church and the people, how they're doing, how are those kind people, how's Dorothy. It's a place where he, along with so many of us, feels at home. You know, in the time we live in, he's disappointed and quite often bewildered by the sort of bully pulpit of the angry, the selfish, you know, the secular society that he hears about and sees on his domestic television. And he yearns and he loves the comfort of tradition that we have. I think the broad church, I think, is exactly where my father lies. But in our life here, there's a cadence and a beauty to our worship together that spreads, you know, far beyond Rye, you know, to my father, but also whether just down the road to Caritas or to Haiti. You know, we are involved. We're making a difference in a tiny way, and we're part of a broader family. Community. There's something special about the community that we have here at Christ Church. You know, I personally notice it every day, and it touches me in so many ways, some tiny, some incredibly significant. You know, I see James, usually I'm sitting behind James every week. He'll give me that learned look, ask how things are going. You know, I'll see Brad on the platform at Metro North, and he'll give me a nod and try and push me off. There's always, as I said, the smile from Dorothy during the service. And even on Wednesday evenings, I come in and I listen to the choir at practice when I pick up Teague. It's a true delight. It's a free, marvellous concert that I take great personal satisfaction from. It's just marvellous. And then also, like this morning, we have a succinct reading by one of our young parishioners. Was it Ava this morning? Led very much by Mary McCarthy, but it's just marvellous to see the younger parishioners involved every day. And also, of course, there will be, unless I'm doing here, Rye Shrug from Bob, who when a line of liturgy may come out in an interesting way. And then, of course, there's a particular cat, the Thorns cat, who merrily owns the show. Not quite as dominating as Colin's cat, who used to actually come and join the service, but yeah, there and keeping, and again, one of those marvellous things of our parish community. Every one of these experiences, and I'm already going on far too long, and I apologise because it is stewardship, but you're meant to suffer a bit. But every one of these experiences is special, and it shows that we are living in our own way, you know, a vibrant community at work and also at peace, which is, I think, marvellous for us today. And now coming on to commitment. This is something personally that I find incredibly hard. From my backgrounds in the Church of England, where stewardship wasn't such a big, they used to have money in those days. But I work in an industry that for maturing workers, and I fall into that category now, it's increasing a sort of no benefit, short term gig economy. So a pledge and a financial commitment becomes harder every year. And I'm sure I and our family are no exception to many of us here. You know, especially sometimes where you don't really know if you can pay the mortgage, you have to pray that you don't get sick. But we do pledge, and we can and contribute where we can or what we can, and we contribute where we can in as many ways, and we hope we can continue to do the same. And on the final, the other point on responsibility, I stand here and I'm very honoured to serve on the vestry of Christ Church. Each of us on the vestry has a particular area of responsibility. I picked up buildings and grounds for some reason, which I actually love. It's a very satisfying area to work in. You do look up on a rainy day like this and hope that nothing's coming through the ceiling. But you know, I'll go back to my home parish, which is basically a tiny Saxon edifice. Every 15 years, we just lime wash the interior and to prune the landscaping, we just let some cows out and they merrily eat through the grass and the undergrowth. Quite easy, and it's worked very well for over 1,000 years. However, though, here at Christ Church with our beautiful Victorian edifice, somehow the Victorian artisans didn't have the skills of our 9th century forebears. So every day and every week there's something else that happens that requires maintenance, and it's our responsibility to keep that up. This is very much like painting the George Washington Bridge. You start and you never finish because you have to go back, as if they painted the George Washington Bridge. But it's a never-ending task, and it's a task that with the help of the staff, with Chris and the other staff here, they're always hard at work fixing, triple bidding, negotiating in a crafty way. We had to reinstall a stove in the rectory the other day, and it was just before Memorial Day, and Chris went back to the place where we purchased the stove the next day, and he actually got the Memorial Day discount. So there are little things which actually do make a big difference, because they can save hundreds, if not thousands, of dollars, and it's being done every day here. And like all the other, you know, components of our mission, you know, we spend every penny as wisely as we can to support the wider mission of Christ Church. So to close, you know, like our fellowship as a parish and our responsibility for this building, stewardship is our investment. It's very easy to defer, and it never gets easier and cheaper to do that maintenance. And sadly, stewardship can remind us that the benefits of our parish has a cost, but as we know, it's a